I don't know what you eat. What do you eat to stay so young? You don't look a day older than you did when I met you 40 years ago.
Gladys puts formaldehyde in my coffee every morning. We were someplace at a fair. Some woman came up, and she was very nice, a nice comment, just like Bill Anderson did. Said, how do you, asked Gladys, how does he stay looking so healthy? She said, I put formaldehyde in his coffee every morning. She said, oh. She said, no, don't do that. But you never know what people are going to say when they come up to you at a show.
No.
You have no idea what they're going to say. Sometimes they don't know what to say, so they say something stupid. But we play the Missouri State Fair, my home fair, every year, and have for about 35 years. 2 years ago, a guy came up to me at the fair after the show, and he said, knowing that I have a younger brother who is a doctor in Sedalia, Missouri, he said, it must be nice to have a doctor in the family to take care of your health needs. I said, my brother don't do nothing for me. He's a gynecologist. That's true.
What would it take to get a little bit of the auctioneer out of Leroy?
Oh, about $1.50 and a ballpoint pen.
I think we could probably do that.
I don't know. Can you guys see me over there? When I do this, I want to hear a chord. You know the routine? Okay. Maybe I better stand up, because I'm kind of short. I'm not like Jimmy C. They can't see me 4 feet away. Okay, what's the first chord on this thing? Okay, you know what to do. Okay. Hey, well, all right, sir, here we go there, and what are they going to give for? I'm at 25 to get 30 now, 5 for a bid to 5 and a $40 and a pound there. There was a boy in Arkansas who wouldn't listen to his ma when she told him he should go to school. He'd sneak away in the afternoon, take a little walk, then pretty soon you'd find him at the local auction barn. He'd stand there to listen carefully, then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry, gotta make my mark and be an auctioneer. All together now, $25 bid and I'll put it down to 30, bill and give me 30, make it 30, bid and mama, 30 down to bid and give me 30, hurrah, a $30 bid. $30 bid and I'm 35, will they give me 35, I'll make it 35, a bid and 35, who would have bid it at a $35 bid? As time went on, he did his best, and all could see he didn't jest. He practiced calling bid both night and day. His pap would find him behind the barn just working up an awful storm as he tried to imitate the auctioneer. Then his pap said, son, we just can't stand to have a mediocre man selling things at auction using our good name. I'll send you off to auction school, then you'll be nobody's fool. You can take your place among the best all together now. $35 bid and the $40 bid, give me 40, make a 40 bid, and I want a $40 bid, give me 40, a $40 bid. $40 bid now, 45, will they give me 45, to make it a 45, bid, 45, 45, who would have bid it at a $45 bid? You're not singing. 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 So from that boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He came back home a full-fledged auctioneer. Then the people came from miles around to hear him make that rhythmic sound that filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. His fame spread out from shore to shore. He had all he could do and more. Had to buy a plane to get around. Now he's the tops in all the land. Let Paul give that man a hand. He's the best of all the auctioneers. $45 bid, another $50, 50 bill. They give me 50, make a 50 bid on a $50 bill. They give me 50, hurrah, bid on a $50 bill. $50 bid now, 55 bill. They give me 55, make it a 55 bill, a 55. Sold that goat for the $50 bill. Hey, well, all right, sir, open the gate and let them out and walk them, boy. Here we come, a lot number 29 in. What are they going to give for? I'm at 35, to give 40 now, 5 for a bit to 5 and a $50, and then give 50, and I think I'm at $55 and I'm at there. Hey, Bill, Lynn Anderson, Lynn Anderson used to do that on the Lawrence Welk Show.
Helen Cornelius used to do it too.
You said everybody sang along. Lynn was singing and Johnny County.
Yeah.
Y'all, let's hear y'all do a chorus of it.
Uh-oh. Oh, wow.
Helen can do it. Helen Cornelius can do it.
Who's going to be 30? Who to make it $30 bid? $35 bid or not 35? Who to give us 35 minutes? 35 minutes, 35 sold enough for a $35 bid.
Oh, that was very nice. Very nice, Lynn Anderson. Very nice.
Gladys sings harmony with Matt. She, when Gladys used to work the show with us, sang in harmony, she sang it in harmony with me.
How much paper did it take to write that song?
I used up a whole roll of toilet paper on that. No, I'll tell you something. I'm not a songwriter like some of you guys are. Bill Anderson is a master song crafter. I wrote one song and quit while I was ahead. But I didn't plan to write the song. The best $300 I ever spent was going to auctioneer school, and which I did in 1951. And years later, I was in Korea riding up down those dusty roads, and Bill probably has had this experience writing songs. They just come to you out of the air. And I know Jimmy Dean said he wrote Big Bad John in about 7 minutes on an airplane, wrote it down on an envelope. But the words of the music to that song started coming to me as I rode up and down that road one day, and I didn't pay any attention to it. About two or three days later, here it came again, and I didn't pay any attention to it. About the fourth time these words and the music started coming to me, I thought, somebody's trying to tell me something. So I went back to my squad tent, got my Sears Roebuck guitar, and sat down and wrote the song. It didn't take very long to write it, but it took me 2 weeks to learn it after I wrote it. because an auctioneer doesn't do the same thing twice, but I had to learn it to do it exactly the same way every time. And the rest of this story is it's a true story about a man named Ray Sims. He's a second cousin of mine, the best auctioneer that ever walked. And the only thing that's not true in that song is there was a boy in Arkansas. He came from Missouri, where I came from, but nothing rhymes with Missouri. And you can't make anything rhyme with Missouri. Maybe Bill could, but I can't.